Hi friends, welcome back to my channel. In today's video, I am going to share with you all my vegetarian take on the Mexican recipe called veg enchiladas. Now, first of all, it took me a while to pronounce this thing the way I am. So if the pronunciation is not perfect, I'm extremely sorry. Secondly, I'd like to mention that the research of mine has shown that the filling of this recipe is usually made by multiple different things by individuals. So I decided that I'll create the filling out of paneer and some vegetables. Hopefully you people will enjoy today's recipe. If you people do, then do give it a huge thumbs up and tell me in the comment section below if you people try this, and let me know how do you people felt about my vegetarian take on it. So let's get started. I'm going to prepare the sauce first. So I'm going to add some garlic in butter. This recipe is usually made in butter. So I'm going to add some garlic in it. These are like 4 to 5 cloves, crushed garlic. And then I'll be adding some flour to it. You can use corn flour or maida over here. I have used corn flour. Usually I prefer using corn flour over maida in terms of sauces. So here, when it starts appearing like this, like a little bit loose, you're going to add some red chili powder. The sauce is supposed to be red, so over here you can use some Kashmiri red chili powder as well. And in case you have that, you'll get a better result in terms of color. And then after, you know, cooking it a little bit, I'm going to add tomato puree in it. Here I have used 4 tomatoes. The sauce is supposed to be savory in taste. So you need to use those tomatoes, those yellow tomatoes that are sour in taste. Post it starts to thicken up, you need to add some pepper powder in it, salt over here, and then oregano. And it has some little bit Indian spicy taste as well. So I have used some jeera powder in the sauce and some coriander powder in the sauce as well. And then I'll be mixing it all up. I have added salt at the same stage. Just make sure that the balance of salt and the savouriness of tomatoes is exact. Taste kar lijiye beech mein, in case if you feel it is necessary for you to taste it as well. And you need to wait for the sauce to get entirely thickened up before you add up some tomato ketchup to it. And this will add taste and reduce a little bit of tanginess. And at the end, I'll be adding a little bit, like a dash of sugar to it as well. Now let's prepare the marination. The thing that I mentioned that is going to have my take on it, it's this thing, the filling. So here I have added 5 to 6 garlic cloves, crushed garlic cloves in oil. And then I have added 2 onions to it and 1/2 capsicum to it, just a little bit of capsicum. Like, I am going to prepare only 2 wraps. So if you want to prepare 4 wraps, then you can increase the quantity as you people wish to. And I've added some green chilies to it as well. You can upscale the vegetables however you want. Here I've added salt, coriander powder, jeera powder, a little bit of chaat masala to it as well. So the filling, the masalas, the spices of fillings are supposed to be like balanced, kyunki isme sauce bhi padega. So here I'm adding some pepper powder to it as well. I've added some pepper powder to it as well, I'm sorry, and some coriander powder. And then I'm gonna roast the masalas together. After that, I'll be crumbling some paneer. At this stage, you can add rajma if you want to. At this stage, you want to eat. If you want to add some mushrooms, you can add mushrooms as well. But I was planning on preparing only paneer's filling. So here my paneer is roasted. I have added the prepared sauce to it, like 2 big scoops of sauce. And here my filling is ready. Now let's prepare the tortilla wraps. Now I'm not going to say that this is the exact recipe of the tortillas, because that is made up of corn flour, I guess. But I didn't had it. What I had was maida, so I decided I'll create it out of that. So in maida, I've added salt, baking powder and butter. And I have created with lukewarm water a dough, a sticky sort of dough. And then I am going to create tortillas out of it. So you need to make them thin. They are supposed to be very, very thin in texture. So as much as you can roll out, it's going to be better for you. So the thinner, the better. That's what the key is. And then I'm going to go ahead and cook them on a hot tawa. So here you can see me cooking it on a hot tawa. So just go ahead and press it down and cook it. So post your tortilla, the wraps are ready. You're absolutely ready to assemble the entire dish. And here is the assembly part. So I'm just going to take one wrap and I'm going to add the vegetable filling on top of it. And then I'm going to add some cheese. Here I have a combination of mozzarella cheese and processed cheese. Both are grinded together. And then I'm going to just roll it all around. You don't need to add sauce over here because we have already used sauce in the filling. So here we are not going to use the sauce. We're just going to add up the filling and cheese so that the cheese melts inside the wraps when you are baking it. So here I am going to wrap the other tortilla as well. And post wrapping it, it's time for us to enter it in a baking dish. So here I am, using the sauce on the base of the dish. You can use whatever dish you like, the baking dish, whatever dish you feel like. A glass dish usually helps you to not to burn the entire recipe. So that is why I prefer using a glass bowl for this kind of recipe. So here I am dividing the tortillas into two different parts. And then I'm gonna place it into the bowl because my bowl was not that big. If you have a giant bowl, then you can use the entire roll like that only. You can keep the entire roll like that only. So just fix it up as well, as good as possible. I'm extremely sorry if you feel that I am a little bit distracted, but my son, he is continuously pulling me, he wants me to go out with him. So I'll just finish the voiceover and go. So here I am topping it up with some sauce, the residual amount of sauce. This sauce is the base, this sauce is the actual base of this dish. So you need to make sure that you add as much sauce you have, like as much as possible, jitna ho sake utna dal dijiye. So here I'm adding the sauce on all the corners of the dish. Every corner needs to be coated with the sauce before you top it off with cheese. So here, as I mentioned, I have a combination of mozzarella and processed cheese. I've grated it together. I am going to top it off. The cheese tastes extremely good in this. So add up as much as you can, as much as you can afford, because I can understand. So here I'm adding up some cheese and then I'm going to keep it in the microwave. And I have preheated the microwave on 180 degrees Celsius and I'm going to keep it for 30 to 35 minutes. So I have bathed in that duration and here I am going to take it out and serve it. It turned out to be delicious, my friends, and it was very, very nutritious as well, the filling and everything like that. Next time I'll definitely try it with the help of wheat flour as well, so that maide ka complication na lage. So if it will turn out good, I'll share with you people that as well. Hopefully you people must have enjoyed this video. If you people did, don't forget to give this video a huge thumbs up and don't forget to subscribe to the channel if you people haven't already. I'll see you guys in my next video. Till then, stay blessed and take very good care of yourself. Bye-bye.